Yeah, week one was interesting because we were going into the game knowing we could win and knowing we were going to win. Like, I had no doubt in my mind that we were going to win that game. But, like, everyone else that wasn't us, I guess teams we play against, didn't think we were going to win. And they just expected London to destroy us because they won last year. So going into it, it was like, all right, well, let's see how they are. Like, I wonder how they play, you know? Like, it's always that first ever map in a series where it's like, okay, you, like, figured them out. And as soon as that first map went down, I was like, okay, nice. Like, this is gonna be, we got this.
After the week one, we were obviously super happy, proud of what we did, but we know as well that it's just the beginning. Like, we don't have to stop on it and think too much about this victory. We really need to. What we want is not beat London. It's really be the best place possible in the league and win every match.
It's all about mindset. It's not about skills. It's about you're gonna play together. It's about how you're gonna feel and how you're gonna be on stage. How you're gonna communicate with your mates and these kind of things. So yeah, moral and psychology and mental preparation.
The Spitfire game was like 3 months for this, our debut, and then for week two, it's kind of like, okay, now everyone knows that we're the real deal, and so we're just trying to like refine what we're doing. We're like looking at where our weaknesses were.
Outside the game, everybody's involved in order to help the team. It could be players who are actually playing and even players who are not playing yet. We have all natural leadership and we are all involved in it, so it's easy to talk to everyone, and we wanted this atmosphere because we want to be able to talk to every player and every player to be able to talk to us if necessary in order to all move on and help the team to move forward.
I feel like right now the standings in scrims, or at least with teams, there's like, I don't know, 6 or 7, maybe 8 teams who are all super close. And Arsenal Gladiators are in that like little niche bracket.
I already know that Hydration and Sure4 can both play Sombra. They also have been talking about being like a dominant 3-3 team themselves. So I think they're gonna wanna kinda showcase that and show off like, oh, we can beat Paris in 3-3.
I think it will be a hard match, it will be difficult, but I'm pretty sure that if we have the answer and if we play correctly, I'm confident to, you know, in our chance to beat them.
Like, Gladiators is a really strong team. Sure4 is really good. I think they'll be a much tougher opponent. The game will be much closer compared to the London game. I mean, I'm excited because I do think that they believe they have a better GOATs than us. So I don't think they're going to do anything special with DPS. They just want to match us as much as possible, I think. So it's going to be interesting to see who has the better GOATs in the day.
After that, Brigitte ultimate is down. They're probably trying to go in. There we go. Roar trying to get in. Oh, bigger shatter! But the Maywall just in time. They can't quite capitalize. Gives Paris the opportunity to drop that sound barrier.
Cruz is a shot caller, and as a shot caller, he has to have leadership in game.
I do think I'm the closest thing to a leader in this team, yeah. But I don't think our team necessarily needs a full-on leader like other teams do. And in game, like, sure, I'm like a leader. I mean, alongside Ben, we do most of the calling. We make sure to like be like, all right, guys, come on, we got this. Keeping everyone in check in game. So yeah, leadership in game, out of game is not needed.
He got it off just in time. Clutch sound barrier from Cruz. What a hero, but they still need to win the fight.
It's not that I go out of my way to be vocal. It's just what I want to do. Like, I don't try, I don't put it on. It's just what I want to do. It's like I always just find myself doing it. You know, it's like, it just feels natural.
Gladiator is locked up by the pillar. Finzi with the self-destruct grabs 3. Welcome back to the Overwatch League, LA Gladiators versus Paris Eternal, 1-1 right now. Gladiators, it's a brawl, everybody going different directions. Players dropping left and right, but it is the Gladiators looking for more of those kills. That was a great charge of Ben Best, though. Boyd does get defected, and now he comes in with the Earth Shatter. Gladiators falling apart at the very end, and they took point A, but they are getting nothing on B.
They are not getting a darn thing, Gulla.
Big opportunity to finish off A, maybe even a bit quicker than they expected. Nico gets rezzed too, but Cruz paid for it with his life. Soon trying to protect his teammate, Boyd defect. Here comes a pulse bomb now. He doesn't even need to save that. Big Goose staying alive. Boyd gets defect again. I can't believe how long they're going to nearly force an OT, but it's not enough. Paris Eternal finally getting the win in that series. A man doesn't get too much more shields up than that. Gladiators with a great defense. In the end, though, Paris Eternal comes out on top.
It was really stressful, to be honest. You don't leave this kind of close games every day, and I hope we won't leave it during all the season. We will be able maybe to close the games a bit faster. We made mistakes, but I'm really happy about players' performance and happy that we take the win today. I think the players were focused. We were able to hear the communication, so I can't say they were focused, but we were a bit too split, and sometimes they get killed. So we just have to be more disciplined in this kind of situation, and we will work next week on it. I'm really proud of what Fidin did today. He really improved during all this week. He focused really hard on the work in order to improve and to be at the level he was here in the game. It's the real Finzi we see. We saw the real Finzi today, and I really hope we will see him again like this during all the season.
Yeah, I didn't expect I got MVP. I had no clue till someone told me, but it feels good.
Yeah, sure.
They just played like really fast-paced and kind of just forced mistakes out of us, even though we did some mistakes just by our own. But yeah, they played really well and they were really good, and they just made us play a bit worse, but we played super well. Yeah, I'm super proud of them.